You're listening to The Hour of the Time. I'm Pooh.
And I'm William Cooper.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'll be in to tuck you in later.
All right.
Good night, baby.
Good night.
Ladies and gentlemen, as most of you know, there may be some of you out there who do not, the Hour of the Time is leaving WWCR, and our last broadcast date on WWCR will be the last weeknight of the month of August. We will begin broadcasting on our new network on Monday, August the 19th. We will be simulcasting. We will be broadcasting on WWCR and our new network, and we will remain on this satellite. And I will let you know later in the week exactly what shortwave frequency. Will also be on another satellite, I understand. And over a period of time, we'll be picked up by some AM stations across the country. And, of course, that's up to the AM stations whether they pick up this broadcast or not. You all have an opportunity. And based upon some of the other programming that they're carrying, I have no reason to believe that they will not. So, that is encouraging, ladies and gentlemen. And I think we'll be a lot better off. In the meantime, I want to thank everyone at WWCR who has helped make this broadcast possible over the last 4 years, and in particular Adam Locke, who has been sort of the guy who takes all the complaints and helps everybody and tries to make things work and make things better and interfaces. And if it weren't for Adam Locke, I got to tell you, WWCR probably wouldn't have any broadcasters, because if everybody had to talk to George McClintock, they just would go somewhere else, because that guy, you know, you pay him good money. You're paying that station good money, and then you have to put up with somebody like George McClintock. It's just, it's uncalled for. Nobody should ever have to do that. It's like going in and paying $1,000 for a stereo set, and the salesman slaps you in the face. That's how George McClintock is all the time. That's how he's always been. I can't tell you how many times I've had to hang up on George McClintock in the middle of a conversation. I wish I could count the times. And I can't tell you how many times Adam Locke has gone out of his way and risked the wrath of George McClintock and the station management to help me and many other people who broadcast on WWCR. And I can't tell you, you have to interface with the man over a long period of time to understand what a decent gentleman and a wonderful person Adam Locke really is. And, of course, there are a lot of other people at WWCR nobody ever hears about, nobody ever talks to, but if it weren't for them, there just wouldn't be any broadcast. So to all of you at WWCR who have helped make this broadcast a success over the last 4 years, I want to thank you sincerely from the bottom of my heart. I am sorry that I have to leave WWCR, but really your station manager has given me no choice. Nobody who has any decency or any honor could remain with a station after they have been lied to for 4 years and treated in the manner that this broadcast and this host has been treated. By the station manager, not by the rest of you. There are three frequencies on WWCR, which go 24 hours a day, ladies and gentlemen. And those frequencies, I have been promised for 4 years, an earlier time slot, wherever one came up, that I would be the first one that they would call. They've never called me once for an earlier time slot, ladies and gentlemen. Not once, ever. And I know, and so have you known, that time slots have come up on the various three frequencies over and over and over again over the last 4 years. I was never called, never notified, never given an opportunity to take an earlier time slot. And was promised that when Tom Valentine retired or left the air, if he ever did, that I would be the first one that they would call to fill that two-hour time slot 5 nights a week. And not only was I not the first one that they called, but when I called to ask if I could have that time slot, I was told by George McClintock that this broadcast is too controversial to air at an earlier time slot. Well, George, which time slot are you talking about? Because right now they're listening to me on the West Coast at 9 p.m. East Coast, it's midnight. So which time slot are you talking about? You know, if I were to go into that old time slot on the East Coast, it would be 10 p.m. Are you trying to tell me that the 9 p.m. audience on the West Coast is a different kind of audience than it is at 10 p.m. on the East Coast? I don't think so, George. I think you're full of hot air, and I think you're full of bullshit. And because of that, you've not only lost Tom Valentine, you've lost the hour of the time, and you've lost a great source of revenue for your broadcast. Not only that, but whoever fills these time slots is going to be competing with me, and I have the largest shortwave listening audience in the world, bar none. And I got to tell you, while I wish them well, I don't know who they are. I know that they're going to suffer because of that. And you're the one, George McClintock, who has caused it. Don't go away, folks. I'll be right back after this short pause.
Where the great wrath are stored, he has moved the faithful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. I have seen him in the watchfires of 100 circling camps. They have built him an altar. In the evening news and tents, I have read his righteous sentence by the dim and flaring lamps. His day is marching on. Oh,
ladies and gentlemen, another of my predictions just came true at the Republican National Committee, convention, I should say. Another one of my predictions just came through at the Republican National Convention. Remember I told you at the beginning when Pat Buchanan began running for president, I told you that his whole purpose was to take the attention of the disenchanted from the Republican Party and give them the illusion that they had a leader. I told you that he didn't have a chance in hell of being nominated. And I told you that when it was all over, he would stand up before his followers and tell them to unify behind the Republican Party and vote for Bob Dole. And that's exactly what he did. That is exactly what he did. He could have taken those people and created another third party. He could have taken those people and he could have garnered control of the Republican Party. Pat Buchanan badmouthed the militias, and he badmouthed a lot of good American patriots, whom he called radicals. Just who was he representing? Well, folks, I'll tell you. He was representing exactly who I told you who he was representing, the New World Order. Pat Buchanan is a Knight of Malta. He wrapped up his racist, never-say-die presidential campaign by calling an uneasy truce with the Republican Party. It was all an act, at least through Election Day, but some of his supporters are still resisting. On the eve of the Republican National Convention, Buchanan seemed on the verge of endorsing Bob Dole. He stopped short of uttering those words during an emotional speech Sunday to the volunteers and supporters he calls the Buchanan Brigade. What a joke that is. In fact, he mentioned Dole only in passing and didn't refer to running mate Jack Kemp at all, even though he has said Dole's choice for the number two spot would be a key factor in his endorsement decision. Instead, this is what he said, what amounts to the same thing as saying vote for Bob Dole. He said it is time for a party truce, and he urged his followers to join together in common cause to defeat Bill Clinton exactly as I told you he would do when he first announced that he was going to run for the presidential candidacy. The crowd at the Republican National Convention hooted down Oliver North, one of the warm-up speakers, when he said it would be counterproductive for Buchanan supporters to start a new third party. You see, Buchanan has ignored his own supporters. Buchanan's speech was interrupted 9 times by the adulatory crowd, which rose to its feet to clap and shout, "Go, Pat, go!" And all throughout the time, you could hear people yelling, "Third party! Third party! Third party!" Buchanan, who was a lifelong Republican who supported Barry Goldwater's campaign, and was an aide to Presidents Nixon and Reagan, told the crowd, "America does not need a third party. What we need is a fighting second party that not only preaches but practices a conservatism of the heart. What unadulterated puke bullshit." Heralding the support garnered by his new conservatism, Buchanan hinted he might make another run for the presidency in the year 2000. What a joke. "The old era is over," he said. "The old order is passing away," he said. "It may bristle and it may resist, but within this party, a new party is being born." And with those words, he spoke the truth. The old era is over. The old order is passing away. The new world order is emerging. He ended his speech, ladies and gentlemen, by saying this, and I quote, Buchanan said this, quote, "I hope that the stone that the builders rejected becomes the cornerstone of the Republican Party." And all of those who have studied the mystery religion of Babylon and the Masonic order know exactly what that means. The cornerstone is the capstone that is now missing from the pyramid, ladies and gentlemen. And when you see it put into place, America will be dead and gone And if it's even allowed to be in the history books, will just be mentioned, not even, ladies and gentlemen, in the manner that we refer to the old Roman Empire. Will be brushed over as if it never existed at all. And what amazed me is all those ignorant fools, the stupid sheeple who sat in that audience and rose to their feet and applauded when he said the words, "I hope that the stone that the builders rejected will become the cornerstone of the Republican Party." And they didn't even know what he said. But they all rose to their feet and cheered and clapped and yelled because, oh, it sounded good, even though those stupid, ignorant sheeple fools had no idea what it was he was talking about. Nothing at all. Bob Dole is a 33rd degree Freemason of the southern jurisdiction of the Scottish Rite. And guess what? His running mate, Jack Kemp, Representative Jack F. Kemp, Republican, has been elected to receive the Scottish Rite 33rd degree and become honorary member of the Supreme Council of the Northern Masonic Jurisdiction. Kemp is a member of Fraternal Lodge F and AM in Hamburg, is a member of Palmoni Lodge of Perfection, the 14th degree, Palmoni Council, Princes of Jerusalem, 16th degree, Buffalo Chapter of Rose Cross, that's right, the Buffalo Chapter of the Rose Cross, 18th degree, and he is a member of the Knights Templar of the Buffalo Consistory, 32nd degree. The 33rd degree is to be conferred upon Representative Jack Kemp at the next annual session of the Supreme Council in September 1987 in Boston. How do you like those apples, ladies and gentlemen? And you think that you have a choice in who you vote for? You think your vote is going to end the New World Order? I got to tell you, if Bob Dole is elected president, he will be worse than you ever dreamed that Bill Clinton could be. Bob Dole is no conservative. He's no Republican. He's a counterfeit, just like old Newt Gingrich. Bob Dole, throughout his career, has pretended to be a Republican, but every single time he has welched on his promise to the people and has voted for liberal bills, liberal laws. He voted for NAT and GAFTA after promising the American people that he would defeat those. He promised the American people he would repeal the assault weapons ban. Not only has he not done it, he's not going to do it. If he becomes president, he will not do it. Instead, he will pass and he will implement even tighter arms control, gun bans, and weapons registration laws, because that's what the New World Order demands. The article I read to you about Jack Kemp is from the Buffalo News. That's right, the Buffalo News from Buffalo, New York, Thursday, October 16th, 1986. The 33rd degree, right from the article I'm quoting, is to be conferred at the next annual session of the Supreme Council in September 1987 in Boston. You see, now you're going to have two 33rd degree Freemasons if the Republicans get elected. Right now you got a Freemason in there, a communist, full-blown Marxist. How long is it going to take for the American people to wake up? Huh? Oh, what? I can't believe it. I sat there watching these stupid, ignorant sheeple fools as they rose to their feet and applauded and yelled and screamed with tears running down their face. As Pat Buchanan said, "And I hope that the cornerstone that the builders rejected will become..." Let me backtrack. He said, "I hope that the stone that the builders rejected will become the cornerstone of the Republican Party. I hope the stone that the builders rejected will become the cornerstone of the Republican Party." Oh, brother. What am I going to do with you, ladies and gentlemen? And there are many of you out there who still think the term New World Order was penned by George Bush and that it is something new. Well, let me read to you something that was written March the 9th, 1943. In fact, it was acted on March the 9th, 1943 by the Pennsylvania State Senate in their Senate Concurrent Resolution, serial number 113, Legislative Journal, page 711, by Messrs. Farrell, Carr, and Woodring, providing for a declaration of the Federation of the World in the Senate, March 9th, 1943, State of Pennsylvania. And I'm just going to read you the high points. "Whereas it is necessary at the present juncture of human affairs to enlarge the basis of organized society by establishing a government for the community of nations in order to preserve civilization and enable mankind to live in peace and be free, the following principles and objectives are hereby enunciated in the Declaration of the Federation of the World. Communities may exist for a time without being incorporated, but under the stress of adversity, they disintegrate unless legally organized." Talks about integrating the regions. Talks about becoming a bulwark. Talks about the cornerstone, the foundation of democracy, the enlightened sense of obligation. These are all Masonic buzzwords, ladies and gentlemen. Those spiritually cosmic forces which visit the world at critical periods in human history to shape the destinies of men. If democracy wins, the nations of the earth will be united in a commonwealth of free peoples, and individuals, wherever found, will be the sovereign units of the new world order. March 9th, 1943. And those of you in Pennsylvania wonder why your state is doing the things that it's doing? They passed this resolution in 1943. And I'll bet you that they passed it in almost every state of the Union around the same time, or at least in many of the states, in particular on the eastern seaboard where socialism rules. Democracy, ladies and gentlemen, is a code word for socialism. This is not a democracy, never was, never was supposed to be, never can be, if it remains, and if you remain free. Lenin, that's right, Lenin, V.I. Lenin, the man who started the Bolshevik Revolution and founded the Soviet Union, V.I. Lenin said that democracy is indispensable to socialism. You see, this nation was founded as a republic, and most of you don't even know what that word means, unfortunately. Now I'm going to read to you House Concurrent Resolution 206. Or let me read to you, before I read House Resolution 206, let me read to you the speech on the floor of the House by Mrs. Jackson, or Ms. Jackson Lee of Texas. And this was done August the 2nd, 1996, in the House of Representatives. It's from the Congressional Record. Ms. Jackson Lee of Texas. Mr. Speaker, it has been a week, but certainly we can say that though we may have disagreed, this Congress has attempted to work on behalf of the American people. I would hope that even if something is threatening, that something is confusing, that there is something that we are not sure of, that we still, as a Congress, have the courage to bring it to the attention of the American people. Today I presented to the American people House Concurrent Resolution 206, which is a sense of Congress that expresses the threat to the security of the American citizens and the U.S. government by armed militia. This may not be a popular stance, but it does us no good to hide from the issue. Mr. Speaker, one of the most energetic promoters of the growing anti-government movement in 1995 was Militia of Montana spokesperson Bob Fletcher. Shortly after a two-ton bomb destroyed the Mira Federal Building in Oklahoma, killing 169 people, Fletcher made an announcement to the press, "Expect more bombs." To date, as a freshman, we have not been able to secure from this House an opportunity to have hearings on the militia. The U.S. government is comprised of democratic institutions, and any change to the government should occur by peaceful means. Americans agree with that. They believe in the First Amendment, the right to freedom of expression, and the right to free association. They do not believe in Oklahoma City, Pan Am 103, or TWA 800. And yes, they do not believe in the confrontation of legitimate law enforcement officers by those who would argue that they have the right to overthrow this government. Several members of the Arizona militia have recently been arrested. Our militias have repeatedly denounced the legitimacy of the U.S. government. Our militia consists of more than 800 groups that are active in more than 40 states. This resolution says that Congress resolves to prosecute and identify all armed conspirators that are brought together to overthrow the government of the United States. It resolves that individuals and groups possessing illegal possession of firearms and explosives should be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law by the Department of Justice. And yes, it resolves that individuals legally possessing firearms and explosives and conspiring to destroy the U.S. government should be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. It is important to note that we are not making an issue out of something that should not be made an issue of. The militia in America are convinced that American people are being systematically oppressed by an illegal totalitarian government that is intent of disarming all citizens and creating one world government. They believe that the time for traditional political reform over their freedom will be secured by resistance to the nation's laws and attacks against its institutions. They are not for peaceful addressing of their grievances. The Patriot press is filled with wild tales of government conspiracies. Some of the most widespread myths assert that the government is using black helicopters to spy on its citizens, mustering Hong Kong police officers to disarm Americans, and implanting electronic monitoring devices in newborn babies. Strange, you say. I think it is important for this Congress to unveil, to disclose all that is being done on behalf of those who would conspire against the U.S. government. No, I am not here to cry fire in a crowded theater, simply asking that we not hide away from the truth. A complex and bizarre theology also helps the Patriots explain their belief and justify their tactics. Patriots as a synonymous name for militia. Many subscribe to the identity religion which holds that white people are God's chosen and that it is their divine duty to battle the satanic beast of government. Though they have no unified leader, these patriots are connected like no rebel force has ever been. On the internet and by fax machine, they share their gripes against government and trade tips on how to avoid tax laws and fight government regulation. Through mail-ordered manuals, they learn how to build bombs and conduct surveillance and disable public utilities. On the weekend, in isolated fields, they practice the art of guerrilla warfare. At public meetings, their rage is rationalized by the propaganda of the movement. I would simply say that I ask my colleagues to join me in supporting House Concurrent Resolution 206. Let us unveil for the American people those who would conspire to overthrow this government and seriously address this issue as Americans believing in peace and believing in democracy. Wow. when we come back after this short break, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to tear this little two-bit lying communist puke-faced scum. No, not scum, sludge to pieces.
My country is of thee, sweet land of liberty. Of thee I sing, land where my father died at freedom. My native country, land of the noble free, thy name my love. I love thy rocks and rills, thy woods and templed hills. My heart
the hour of the time, as usual, is brought to you by Swiss America Trading, the people in Phoenix who specialize in real money, hard assets, non-confiscatable, non-reportable, that you need to protect everything that you have that you've worked for, because everything's going to come tumbling down. Our government is being controlled now by the biggest pack of communist, Marxist liars that have probably have ever lived upon the face of this earth, and they only have one goal. That's to destroy this nation, disarm its people, destroy, completely obliterate the middle class, and bring about a one-world totalitarian socialist government. One of the ways to do that is to collapse the economy. You see, they must eliminate the middle class. Socialism cannot exist in a society that has classes. A middle class is an anathema to a socialist society. You're going to find that as the years go by, it gets harder and harder to make a decent living. Oh, yes, and your standard of living is going to go down lower and lower and lower until eventually it reaches the same level in every country around the globe, except for those very rich individuals who are controlling and pulling the strings for all of this baloney. And if you don't have something to protect yourself, you're going to find yourself in a ditch. With no job, no money, no roof over your head, sick. Trying to explain to your family, your wife, and your children what happened. So if you don't want to have to be able to do that, then I assure you that once that happens, there is not going to be any explanation that is going to calm their fears or cure their illness. Put a roof over their head or feed them. Nope, you're going to be up the creek without anything. So call Swiss America Trading now and get your hands on some real money before all this occurs, and it is going to occur, I can assure you. 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. Do it now. You know how you are. You're just like me and everybody else. You tend to procrastinate. Do it now. One morning you're going to wake up and it's going to be too late. And kicking yourself won't hurt at that point. It won't help either. 1-800-289-2646. Ask for Frank. If he's not there, ask for anybody. Thank them for sponsoring the Hour of the Time. You'll get red carpet treatment, I guarantee it.
Oh, beautiful, for spacious skies. for amber waves of gray, for purple mountain majesties of my love-rooted
talk about this cute-faced, communist, lying Ms. Jackson Lee of Texas. Democrat, of course. Socialist. Marxist. Liar par excellence. She wouldn't know anything about America. If you sat down with her in a library, even the Library of Congress, and made her study for 6 months, even if you gave her the books to read, because Ms. Jackson Lee of Texas doesn't have a brain in her head, she's not an American. Not at all. She's a subversive. She says that there is a threat to the security of the American citizens and the U.S. government by armed militia. She is a liar. It is the armed militia that created this country. It is the armed militia that fought most of the battles that were ever fought in the early days of this country. It was the armed militia who took up their weapons and reported for duty and fought the Civil War to free the slaves. It is the armed militia, ladies and gentlemen, that has always preserved this nation. It has been the armed militia, ladies and gentlemen, that has always been willing and ready to answer the call whenever the call has been sounded. Throughout the history of this country, if there were no threat to the American people, ladies and gentlemen, there would be no armed militia today. If there were no threat to the United States government, there would be no armed militia today. If there were no threat to freedom, there would be no armed militia today. The armed militia in America only springs forth in times of threat to the United States government, to the Constitution for the United States, to the rights of the American people, and to the American people themselves. That is the truth of the matter, Ms. Jackson Lee, liar, puke-faced, Marxist, socialist, subversive. You see, it is Ms. Jackson Lee and those like her in government who are destroying this country, who are destroying government, who are the propaganda experts, who are the liars. She says in 1995, the Militia of Montana spokesman Bob Fletcher, shortly after a two-ton bomb destroyed the Mira Federal Building in Oklahoma, killed 169 people, said, "Expect more bombs." So did I. So did everybody else in this country who has studied Marxism and socialism and how they ride to power over the bones of those killed by terrorism. So yes, you can expect more bombs, you can expect more terrorism, you can expect more of all of it. You can expect more children to be killed, more women to be killed, more buildings to be blown up, and more planes to crash because these puke-faced, lying Marxist socialists, and I'd better not say what I would like to say, will bring those things into being in order to cause the stupid sheeple in this country to get down on their knees and beg for their rights to be taken away so that they can have more security. Don't believe it? Study Marxism. Study socialism. Study communism. And remember, all of these movements started back in the late 1700s. In the late 1700s, ladies and gentlemen, they just didn't start in this century. They're vicious. They believe that the end justifies the means. They will do anything. They will kill any number of people. They will destroy and injure and torture any number of little children to get their way, to get their control, to exercise their torture. And she says it was a 2-ton bomb. Oh, my goodness. She says, to date, as a freshman, we have not been able to secure from this house an opportunity to have hearings on the militia. Well, that's funny. The militia is willing. The militia across this country has called for hearings on the militia. What's the matter with these puke-faced liars? You know why they won't have hearings on the militia? Because the militia is legal. The militia is lawful. The militia has a duty, an obligation, and a responsibility. The Constitution recognizes the militia as pre-existing the Constitution. The second article in amendment grants the right to the people to keep and bear arms. You see, that is the active clause of that article in amendment. She says the government is comprised of democratic institutions, and any change to the government should occur by peaceful means. Well, this is a republic. It is not a democracy. And if it is comprised of democratic institutions, that means socialism has already grabbed a throat hold on the American people. And change to the government is not occurring by peaceful means, ladies and gentlemen. Look around and seeing how many people are being forced to commit suicide, are being destroyed, are being ruined, are being thrown in jail for nothing. Did you know, are you aware of, that right now the United States has the largest prison population per capita of any nation in the world, and they're building more prisons, and they're funding more prisons, and they're building concentration camps and abandoned military bases across this country? She says Americans believe in the First Amendment. That's right. She says they believe in the right to freedom of expression. That's right. And the right to free association. That's right. Ooh. But if you're exercising those rights and you happen to own a weapon, somehow that's wrong? No. Ms. Jackson Lee of Texas, Marxist, socialist, subversive, is wrong. And then she pulls a real cheap propaganda lie, real cheap trick. It is a lie, and everybody out there listening better start writing letters and call them on this lie. She says they do not believe in Oklahoma City, Pan Am 103, or TWA 800. See, I'm really upset about this. When I get upset, my tongue doesn't always go in the right direction, folks, so you'll have to forgive me. I am a passionate man. She says they do not believe in Oklahoma City, Pan Am 103, or TWA 800. And yes, they do not believe in the confrontation of legitimate law enforcement officers by those who would argue that they have the right to overthrow this government. You see, she is claiming that the militia is responsible for Oklahoma City, and that is a lie. The Federal Bureau of Investigation announced early on that the militia had nothing to do with the bombing of the Mira Federal Building at all. That Timothy McVeigh, even though he has not been convicted of any crime, was not associated with any militia, and neither was Terry Nichols. The militia had absolutely nothing to do with Pan Am 103, ladies and gentlemen. Nothing whatsoever. It's already been determined that that was an act of Middle East terrorism.
But yet, Ms. Puke-faced liar, Ms. Jackson Lee, socialist, Marxist, subversive, is trying to make you think that the militia blew up Pan Am 103, that the militia blew up the Alfred K. Mura Federal Building in Oklahoma City. And she's a liar. And then she says, TWA 800. Nobody knows what happened to TWA 800. Nobody. Nobody has any evidence that anything happened to it as of this date, as of this time, much less the militia. We do know one thing. It was shot down by a missile launched from sea. I don't know any militia navies, do you? And then she says they do not believe in the confrontation of legitimate law enforcement officers by those who would argue that they have the right to overthrow this government. The militia is not engaged in any attempt to overthrow the United States government. If the militia must act, it will be to restore the United States government as a constitutional republic and reseat the Constitution for the United States of America in its lawful place as the supreme law of the land. That is the duty, the responsibility of the militia and of every man and woman who have ever taken the oath of enlistment or the oath of a commission in the armed services of any branch of the armed forces of the United States of America. My oath said that I will protect and defend the Constitution for the United States of America against all enemies, foreign and, listen carefully, folks, domestic. It is the duty of the militia. If these puke-faced, lying, Marxist, communist subversives continue to destroy this country, to march against them with weapons, to arrest them, to restore the constitutional republic, to convene constitutional trials where they will be tried by a jury of their peers for treason, and if they are found guilty, hung by the neck until they are dead. The first document in law of this nation is the Declaration of Independence. Read it, ladies and gentlemen. It tells us that if our government ever turns oppressive and subversive, and if it ever becomes a tyrant to the people of this country, that we are to march against those people who perform those acts and instate the government that we wish to have. And we wish the constitutional republic that was guaranteed to us and that was put into place by the founding fathers of this country. Anyone who does not like this country or its government or its constitution simply can get on a plane or a boat and get the flock out of Dodge. You hear me, Ms. Jackson Lee? You Marxist subversive? The purpose of the militia is to suppress insurrection, repel invasion, and execute the laws of the Union. Which means if you're out of the bounds of the Constitution for the United States of America, we are to put you back in those bounds and chain you so that you cannot get back out of those bounds. If you are performing unlawful acts, we are to enforce the laws of the Union. If you are performing an insurrection against this government to destroy it and bring about a world totalitarian socialist government, it is the purpose of the militia to suppress your insurrection. And if you're from a foreign nation and you are thinking about invading the shores of the United States of America, it is the purpose of the militia to repel that invasion. The militia of every state is subject to the call of the governor, provided that the governor is performing within his constitutional capacity and within the limits of the Constitution of his state. If the governor of any state should subvert the Constitution of that state and perform illegal and unconstitutional acts against the people of the state, the militia cannot answer the call of the governor, but must march against that governor to restore the Constitution of that state as the supreme law of that state. That is the tradition and the history of this country. And Ms. Jackson Lee, if you want to start a war real quick, House of Representatives, Senate, if you want to start a war real quick, you just keep messing with the right of the American people to protect themselves against the tyranny of the Marxist subversives who would take this country down and destroy it. You better be listening really well. Your resolution is nothing but a piece of garbage bullshit, and it ain't gonna wash out here in the heartland of America. Not at all. She wants to prosecute and identify all armed conspirators that are brought together to overthrow the government of the United States. Well, the militia would like to prosecute and identify all armed conspirators that are brought together to overthrow the government of the United States also. That is the purpose of the militia. Right now, I would say that there are plenty of armed conspirators in the leadership roles and ranks of the armed forces of the United States of America. Conspirators that are brought together to overthrow the government of the United States. And I think that can pretty well be proven, not only in the higher ranks of the military, but all throughout the bureaucracy of the United States government. They are working in concert with Marxists and socialists around the world to disarm the American people, destroy this country, eliminate the middle class, create a parliamentary regional state under a one-world totalitarian socialist government headed at the United Nations. This is not conjecture. This is not my opinion. I have proven it over and over again on this broadcast by documenting it in the law, in the treaties, in the congressional record, in the Federal Register, in the speeches of these Marxist subversive puke-faced liars. The first issue of Veritas ran six entire pages of nothing but quotes from these lying scum, these traitors. We still have some back issues of issue number one, some copies. You can have it for $5. $5 a piece. Any back issue we have, you can have for $5 a piece. The Patriot Press is filled with wild tales of government conspiracies. Not Veritas, ladies and gentlemen. Nothing is printed in Veritas, and it is thoroughly documented and proven. Thoroughly. Nothing is aired on this broadcast, and it is thoroughly documented and sourced and proven. And you all know that. How does this lying little scum-faced puke Marxist get off calling us conspirators and then say that our press is filled with wild tales of conspiracies? Now, who's the conspiracy nut, her or us? We document and prove what we say. She just makes wild generalizations, spouts a whole bunch of lies, and introduces this as a resolution into Congress. Is Congress full of stupid idiots who have nothing but air between their ears? Is that what you sent to represent you in the House of Representatives, that they hear her get up and make this lie speech and nobody says anything? And it's now in the Judicial Committee, and this is going to come up for a vote. Who's going to vote for it? Who's going to vote against it? You better find out now. And you better find out quick. Yes. Patriots. Look up the definition of the word. Patriots get together and they learn. They learn what's going on. And they pass around documentation. They want to know the truth. They want to stay free. They don't like what's happening to this country. And yes, they are preparing. Not for a conflict that they are going to initiate, but for the final conflict that we know the socialists are going to bring to our doorstep. We will not submit, not ever. We will not disarm. We will not give up our weapons until every bullet is gone. Then you can have them, and we'll take yours. And we'll use yours until every bullet is gone. You have no idea what you are messing with. But you're going to find out if you continue to take away the freedoms and the rights of the American people. The only people in the history of the world who have ever truly been free. And if you think we're going to give that up, the ultimate success of human evolution, you have another think coming, Ms. Jackson Lee. And Ms. Jackson Lee, you better think about it real hard. And all of you other socialist, Marxist, puke-faced, lying propaganda artists, you subversives. It is not the militia that Americans have to fear. It is you. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. God save this republic, and God bless you all.
Tomorrow all the things were gone, worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, but the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that.
Americans, where it is, I know I'm free, and I won't forget the man.
Yeah. Hello?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, this is George from Texas. I had left a message on your machine.
Hold on, George.
Okay.
Hello. Yeah. Fax it to me. Fax it to me. Let me give you the number. You've got a fax machine right down at your local copy store. All you got to do is go down and use it. You don't understand something. I have this terrible habit of jotting things down and losing them. Whatever's sent in the mail or fax does not get lost. Okay? Great. Well, of course. Yeah, fax me all that, would you please? Thank you. Sorry, go ahead.
That's all right. Bill, I've been listening to you for a couple, 3 years now, and every night for the last, well, since last November, when I retired from a place in Houston and moved up here, by the way, that's where Ms. Sheila Jackson Lee was a councilman, or a council Marxist on the city council there. And I want to tell you that tonight, I believe this show is one of the best that I've ever heard you put on the air. It was just awe-inspiring. That's not exactly why I called, but I just wanted to pass that along to you. I need the address for Harvest, or I need a catalog for Harvest so I can order some tapes, in particular the public notice tapes that you did.
Well, you might also want to order issue number 14 of Veritas. You can get it right now for $3.
Okay, I was going to ask you, that all is in print.
Veritas, you can get